Welcome back to my channel Tutor Things. Today in this video we are going to see how to create your first C# application in W3Schools, or also you have to create that in one of the IDE, which is Visual Studio IDE. I'm gonna show you the steps to be followed to create your first C# application. So before getting started into my video, you have to mention one thing, that is, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and click the bell icon so that you will get notified each time when we upload a new video. As you are aware that we have started C# tutorials, where we have done introduction so far as the first video, and this will be the second video. So to get many more concepts related to C#, you should be subscribed to my channel and you have to click the bell icon. So not only C#, that's a programming language related to backend. We have done so many things related to HTML, CSS, Java, jQuery and QuizJS, Angular as a frontend, JS Angular environment, and JS framework, that is Angular, and SQL kind of things, and Azure kind of things, and Java related things, and also jQuery. We have done tutorials in the CS and CS and JS kind of things we have done. So once go to my playlist and check out any of the playlist, may help you to get the things better, as we are explaining everything in detail with a simple English. That will definitely help you to get the things better. So let's see that C# kind of thing. So it is very easy to start a C# by using IDE. IDE is nothing but integrated development environment, which is very easy to edit and compile the code. So as you are, if you are a coder learning any programming language, you will have a specific IDE for the programming, one type of programming language. So you, I think you may aware of what is meant by IDE, such kind of things. So IDE is an integrated development environment, which is used to edit and compile your code. So for C#, I would recommend you to use Visual Studio, as it is very easy to download from the URL that is given by Microsoft, that is visualstudio.microsoft.com. So if you go to this URL, where you can have installation options related to your system specification, so you can install those kind of thing. And so applications written in C# use .NET framework basically, because it will make sense to use Visual Studio, as it is, for most of the people prefer Visual Studio for .NET framework, because as it's a program, the framework and the language, so all these are created by the Microsoft only. So we have to refer that particular IDE for that purpose. And next, how to, I will show you the steps how to you have to install that kind of thing, and how, what are the steps you have to follow to create your first application in Visual Studio. So first you have to install C# in that. So once Visual Studio installer is downloaded and installed, you have to choose this .NET workload and click on the modify and install button. Here you have to select this kind of thing. This particular installer will be open once you install Visual Studio from that URL which I have given. So after that, what you have to do is you have to choose this .NET desktop development, this option here, workload option here. You have to click this box and you have to click modify and install whatever the if it is a modify, you have to modify it's already installed, or if it is first time installing, you have to select this box, because Visual Studio will have this .NET desktop development platform. If it is not present, you can't create a C# programming and everything there. So you have to check this box and you have to modify or install button. So once installation is complete, you have to click on launch button. So installation is completed, then you have to launch your application. So you have to, now you can good to go with Visual Studio. So once start window is open, so you will get screen like this, Visual Studio 2019 we have installed. So now it will give a window like this, where you will have this create new application option. So you will have open a folder option, open a project or solution, or clone or checkout code. These options will be present. You have to choose create a new project, because you have to create a new project now. So once you click on that, so what will tell you means install more tools and features. You have to install more tools and features. You have to click on that part. So now it will give like this, like where you have to select the which solution you want. Likewise, by using the search bar, you can check on that, and also filters also, they are present all languages, or which platform it is related to that. Likewise, If you are not finding anything, you can use this option like install more tools and features here option. If it is present there, then you are good to go with that particular kind of a project like this. Now you have to choose here like console app. So now I want to create my console application in my .NET core. From the list, you have to click on the next button. Once you have selected this kind of thing like console app .NET core, so now you have to click on next button so that it will give the page like this. So where you have to give the name of the project and you have to give a location of that. And here you will have two options. One is it will ask you to create a new solution, or if you are to create new solution, it will ask you the name of the solution. Or if you don't want to create a new solution, if you want in that project only, in that one application, then it will take the same name as a solution name also. So once you have filled all these options, you have to create, you have to click on create button. So Visual Studio will automatically generate some code for your project because default code will come. So whenever you created that application, console application, the code will look something like this. Like it will have some program.cs file. This program.cs file is the first file which will be invoked, so which is a program file. So program.cs is nothing but the class name of which is present in that particular thing. So the class will be the program. In that program class we have void name, so console.readline, and some text which have seen previous example in the previous video. So it will using system kind of namespace. So this is particular namespace, like we are grouping number of classes into some namespace. Here we have only program class here, so that too we have that program class in the namespace called as hello world, so that we can use this namespace in any other kind of thing to refer this particular class program likewise. So similarly we are using here the system is our namespace which is having some other kind of things likewise. So in the system we have console.readline will be the method we are accessing from the console class likewise. So we'll explain all the things in detail in the upcoming videos. Just see how this example, this program file will look like. So like this we'll have. So don't worry if you don't understand the about code. We'll discuss in other videos, like I will explain you what each and every word in this application refers to, what it is actually telling and everything. I will explain in the next video, like C# syntax video, where I will explain you each and every line in detail. So to run this application, once your application is created, the structure will be like this. Like it is having the name of solution name is a hello world, and here is the C#. You can see the here. So program.cs file, and you get this kind of to run this application, we have to click on F5 button on your keyboard, or otherwise you can also go to debug and start debugging, so that it will debug your application and it will execute your code after compilation or everything. The result will look like this. Like in the console you will get result like hello world likewise. So this is the process to run your application, and you have to create a console application. So now you have written and executed your first CSharp program in Visual Studio. So the steps to be followed if you are creating your first CSharp application in Visual Studio. So if you are not using Visual Studio, like you haven't installed that thing, or you don't have any like omissions or a laptop available, if you want to practice or learn CSharp now, so at that time what you can do is you can also create your first CSharp application using W3Schools. If you are at learning stage, you are just learning kind of things, like you can use W3Schools, which is a very cool platform website where you can practice while learning, like at that instant only, by using try it yourself editor, where you will have default code and also you can edit that code and you can run that code and you can see the outputs as you require. So it will make you easy to understand each and every part while you are learning and moving forward likewise things. Here you can see program.cs file they have given. So no need to do an environment setup and everything, which application you have to create, .NET framework is present. So all these things you no need to bother about things. It is already developed and maintained by this website developers only. You can just alter the code so that you can see the outputs by using try it yourself editor. Here you can see, here you will have the same program.cs file content only, like using the system namespace and namespace hello world, where you have class program and method as main method, where you have console.readline and some text is there, so that hello world text is getting as output. So the console.readline will give the output on the console, like it will read this line, so it will write that line on the console. If you remove this part and give any other content also, it will display that when you click on this run button. So hi, you will get output here. Expected output will be high, so you can see the outputs, right? So like this you can practice any kind of examples through this try it yourself editor without a like maintaining your environment IDE and application setup, everything, no need of that. You can just practice by using this W3Schools. So in the next video, I'll explain you the syntax related to C# kind of things. So stay tuned. Until then, keep watching our videos and follow our tutorials and subscribe to my channel to get notified each time when we upload a new video. Like this video if you like, if you understood what is meant by C# and how to create your first application in C# using Visual Studio. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.